think we're getting ready to do something very exciting. Jim, you want to take over?
Sure. So this
Christina, Jessica, please stand by for a call from the President of the United States.
Where's my camera?
I guess it's over to you at this point.
Where's my camera? You tell me. Got a lot of cameras.
It is. It's an exciting day.
It is.
The first all-woman spacewalk underway right now. They're doing very important work. Just so everybody knows, this is a short window for the downlink, and also they've got very busy work to do. They're on the outside of the station, but what a big day. We're thrilled to be here, Mr. President. It's over to you for communicating with them.
Well, I'm thrilled also, and if they're ready, I'm ready.
Okay.
Can we confirm that the link is live?
The link is live. They are listening. They're on the outside of the space station.
Station, this is President Donald Trump. Do you hear me?
We can hear you.
That's great. That's great. I was starting to get worried about you. You're in an interesting place. I thought we may have to be a little emergency work. I don't think that'll ever be necessary with you. The job that you do is incredible. And I'm here with Vice President Mike Pence, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine, and my daughter Ivanka. We're thrilled to be speaking live with two brave American astronauts who are making history, joining us during their spacewalk outside the International Space Station. And this is the first time for a woman outside of the space station. Our flight engineers, Christina Cook, and flight engineer Jessica Meir. And I just want to congratulate you. What you do is incredible. You're very brave people. I don't think I want to do it. I must tell you that. But you are amazing people. They're conducting the first ever female spacewalk to replace an exterior part of the space station. They're doing some work, and they're doing it in a very high altitude, an altitude that very few people will ever see. Congratulations, Christina and Jessica, on this historic event. This is truly historic, and you're right now on television all over the world, so don't get nervous. I'd like to ask you a question. What would you like to tell everyone listening and watching today, especially young women who are interested in space?
There's about a 4 or 5 second delay.
Ah, okay.
Oh, thank you. First of all, we don't want to take too much credit because there have been many other female spacewalkers before us. This is just the first time that there have been two women outside at the same time. And it's really interesting for us. We've talked a lot about it up here. You know, for us, this is really just us doing our job. It's something we've been training for 6 years and preparing for. And so it didn't really, you know, for us, it's just coming out here and doing our job today. And we were the crew that was tasked with this assignment. At the same time, we recognize that it is a historic achievement. And we do, of course, want to give credit to all of those that came before us. There have been a long line of female scientists, explorers, engineers, and astronauts, and we have followed in their footsteps to get us where we are today. We hope that we can provide an inspiration to everybody, not only women, but to everybody that has a dream, that has a big dream, and that is willing to work hard to make that dream come true. Something that all of us that have made our way up here have done all throughout our lives. And I can tell you, the hard work certainly did pay off. I've only been up here a few weeks, actually, about 3 weeks I've been in space, and this is my first flight and my very first spacewalk. So it is a pretty incredible feeling, I'm sure you can all imagine, and it's one that I will never forget. I'm extremely fortunate to be sharing this moment with Christina Cook, who is not only my colleague, but also a very, very close and dear friend. So it's really our honor to be out here working today and to be representing whatever it is that's significant to whatever individual's desires and heart. Thank you.
Well, Christina and Jessica, I would like to, if I could, Just thank you, Jessica. I know that you've been doing this and you've been working hard. And Christine, I've studied your resume. It's really incredible what you've done, what you've both done. Your lives have been incredible. And now you're in a place that, as I said, very few people will ever get that experience. You're doing an incredible job. This is a first step because we're going to the moon and then we're going to Mars. We're launching from the moon, most likely. I seem to think that's the best way of doing it, Jim. So we're launching from the moon, and I just want to congratulate you both. You're very brave, brilliant women, and you represent this country so well. And our country is very proud of you, and we are very proud of you. Millions and millions of people are watching you right now, but I will tell you what you do is really something very special. So first the moon, and then we go to Mars. Thank you both very much. Have a good time. Maybe they didn't like my message. Could be. Anyway, two great women, two great people, and a big danger, not easy. It's not an easy thing to do. A lot of people would take a pass on that one. But they're great women.
Okay, back to the scoop.
I think I heard that. That's the link.
Oh, that's the link.
That's the end of the link. So they heard my message, and they tried to respond.
It's space.
I assume they're okay. Yes. I assume they're okay. Anyway, they're actually outside of the ship, so that's something, right? That's the first time that's taken place.
The first time since 1969 that a president has spoken to astronauts outside of the spaceship. So.
That was a great. That was a great. It's a great thing. When are they coming back? What's the timing?
So each one is different. Christina Cook is actually going to be have the longest single endurance mission.
We're resuming normal operational communications.
Okay. So she's going to be on space station for, I think it's about 10 months, which is the longest we've ever had a woman on the space station ever.
What's the longest for a man?
345 days. So
so why don't you have the woman break the record?
Well, we have a very tight schedule when it comes to windows to get back and forth to the International Space Station. But that's within the realm of what is possible. We're working on schedules, sir.
Well. And next, a woman on the moon, right?
That's right. By direction of the president, we will have the first man, or I should say the first woman and next man on the South Pole of the moon will be American.
And what's your timing on that? Well, better not say it too fast. Get it done before you talk about it.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
The goal is 2024, sir. If all things go according to plan, 2024 is within the realm of what is possible, and we're working hard to make that a reality.
And because of the fact that we've been there, as I've said to you many times, we've been there a long time ago, it's really being done as a launch for Mars. Is that correct?
That's right. We're building a habitat in orbit around the moon, a space station in orbit around the moon, and that will be launching in 2022. And once that is deployed, that will be modified into a Mars ship that will take us all the way to Mars. And between now and then, we want to build a sustainable architecture at the moon. We need to learn how to live and work on another world for long periods of time. And then we go to Mars, because when you go to Mars, Earth and Mars, we're only aligned on the same side of the sun once every 24 months, or 26 months. What that means is we have to be willing to stay.
Right.
We need to learn how to live and work on another world.
Oh, I see. Yeah, right.
So that's what the moon is all about.
That's going to be very interesting. Well, it's very exciting. Exciting times. And that whole program was dead when I took it over, when we came into office. And something that Mike liked very much and I liked very much. And you're both doing a fantastic job, and everybody's doing a fantastic job. It's been totally reinvigorated, I think, to a level that it's never been at. And we're also thinking in terms of defense. We have the Space Force happening. That's going along very nicely, as you know. We're creating a new force, and it's called the Space Force, and that's a big thing. And that'll be working along very closely with you. So that's beyond going to the moon and Mars. That's also defense of our nation.
That's right.
Which is very important.
Anywhere there's commerce, it needs to be defended. And We are industrializing space. It's going to be an export for the United States, and that's going to be very positive. In fact, it already is. We need to grow it. And so we're working very hard to commercialize it, make it an export. And of course, that requires it to be defended just like the high seas for trade.
That's fantastic.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Great job.
Thank you, sir.
Well, thank you very much, everybody. That was very exciting. And these are two great people, and they put themselves at risk for our nation and because they love doing it. And there are few people that have the ability to do something like that. I will say that. It takes a great ability. So thank you all for being here. It's very nice. Thank you.